Our topic of this day is the first empires. Let me ask you a few questions. I'll be showing you some pictures. You will only have to identify the person over here. Now, first person, first picture. Who is he? He is Lord Buddha. Now, second one. Now, who is this person? He is none other than Lord Mahavira. And what was the religion he founded? It was Jainism. Now, next is, can you identify? Immediately you will get who it is. Yes, he is Alexander the Great. And finally, we have the fourth clipping, fourth picture. Now, can you identify this person? He is Chanakya. Chanakya, also known as Kautilya, also known as Vishnu Gupta. Now, we will learn about his names. His names, we actually know him with two names, Chanakya or Kautilya. Now, we will see how these people connected to our lesson, the first empire. Before this, we have learnt in our previous lesson, if you see, we have learned that there were 16 Mahajanapadas in India. We had 16 Mahajanapadas. Of all the 16 Mahajanapadas, you will see that Magadha is the most powerful kingdom. Now, today we are going to learn of how this Magadha turned into an empire from a kingdom. How did Magadha turn into an empire? You know, there's a difference between a kingdom and a empire. Now, what is an empire? When can you call exactly this is a particular vast empire? When can you say? Empire is nothing but it is an, you know, a grouping or consists of several kingdoms or states brought together by one single ruler or one single dynasty. So today we will learn about this powerful kingdom which turned itself into an empire, about Magadha. First, before look at this picture. He is none other than our Alexander. We call him as Alexander the Great. Why do you call him Alexander the Great? Because he is one of the world's greatest conquerors. Now, from where did he start this? Now, what was he like, you know, to which part he was the king? He was the king of Macedonia in Greece. Now, look at his empire. If you see, his empire stretches from Macedonia in Greece to the river Bees in Punjab. This vast is his empire. That means he was been attacking and attacking and attacking and coming down to the country. That means he never faced any failure. He has come to India. One after the other, he is, you know, moving towards India. Now, he turned towards India after the victory of Iran. And he came to India and wanted to cross the river Jhelum. You know, river Jhelum. Now, this side of river Jhelum was being ruled by King Porus. Now, King Porus was actually a very brave warrior, a very good ruler, a wise ruler. But King Porus decided to stop Alexander from crossing the river Jhelum, but could not face his army, could not face the army of Alexander, and was defeated and taken as a prisoner by Alexander. Alexander was such a good person, you know. What did he do is that he appreciated King Porus' patriotism towards his motherland, towards his kingdom, and he gave back his kingdom back to King Porus and accepted King Porus as his friend. Now, after this, Alexander the Great now tried to move towards the river Bees, to river Bees, and wanted to move to this side of the country. He crossed river Ravi, Chenab Ravi, and he marched towards river Bees. Here, Alexander's soldiers did not move further. There were two reasons. Actually, the sources of information give us two reasons. We exactly don't know which one is right. One source says that Alexander's soldiers were tired of, you know, fighting, and they wanted to go back to their motherland. And another says that Alexander's soldiers have come to know that after crossing River Bees, they have to face a very powerful Indian king called the Nandas.